Hi everyone, welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to find the area between two curves. And the graphs that we're given, or the functions we're given, are y equals x plus 1 and y equals 9 minus x squared. And we've been asked to find the area between the two of them, between x equals negative 1 and x equals 2. So the formula that we're going to be using for this problem is the formula we always use for area between curves problems. And we're going to be integrating on the range a to b. And our limits of integration a to b are going to be negative 1 to 2, which have already been provided for us, which is not always the case, but in this case, they've been given to us. And then we're going to be integrating f of x minus g of x. Now, you have to decide which of your formulas or which of your functions is going to be f of x and which is going to be g of x. F of x should be above g of x on the range negative 1 to 2. So one way we can do that is by graphing the function, or both functions. You can see that y equals 9 minus x squared is the purple graph here, and y equals x plus 1 is the orange graph. If we graph them, and then we have here the line x equals negative 1 and the line x equals 2, you can see that 9 minus x squared is above x plus 1 on the range, negative 1 to 2. So that gives us an indication that f of x is going to be 9 minus x squared and g of x is going to be x plus 1. The other way you could figure this out is plug in any number that's between negative 1 and 2, so you could pick like 0 or 1, and plug into both functions, and whichever one is higher will be f of x, and then the lower one will be g of x. So having determined that 9 minus x squared is f of x, we can go ahead and plug in both of our functions to the integral here. So 9 minus x squared will be f of x, and we will subtract from that g of x, which is x plus 1. And we're going to be integrating from negative 1 to 2. So now that we've got this set up, we're going to start simplifying. We'll end up with 9 minus x squared minus x and minus 1 when this negative sign carries over to both of these terms here. When we combine constants, we'll end up with 8 minus x squared minus x. And then we can start integrating. When we take the integral of this first term here, 8, we'll get 8x. Taking the integral of negative x squared, we add 1 to the exponent to get 3, and then we divide the coefficient, which is the 1, by the new exponent, 3, and same here with this x term. We add 1 to the exponent, 1 plus 1 gives us 2, and we divide our coefficient 1 by our new exponent, which is 2. And then we're going to be evaluating between negative 1 and 2. So when we plug in our definite integral numbers here, we plug in 2 first because it's the top number, and then we always subtract here in the center and then plug in our bottom number, which is negative 1. And when we start simplifying, we'll get 16 here for the first term. 2 cubed is 8, so we end up with a negative 8 thirds here for the second term. 2 squared is 4. 4 times 1 half is 2, so we end up with a negative 2. And then, of course, a negative 8 here for 8 times negative 1. Negative 1 cubed is negative 1, so we end up with negative 1 times negative 1 third gives us a positive 1 third. And then negative 1 squared here is a positive 1, so we end up with a negative 1 half for this last term. And then when we distribute the negative sign here in the middle, all of our terms in the first half here stay the same. We end up with a positive 8, because we have negative times a negative here, a negative 1 third, and a positive 1 half. So now if we combine the 16, the negative 2, and the 8, 16 minus 2 gives us 14, plus 8 gives us 22. We have a negative 8 thirds and a negative 1 third gives us a negative 9 thirds, and we leave the 1 half alone. These are just basic simplification steps. Now we're going to find the lowest common denominator, which is 6. And here this 22 will multiply by 6 over 6 to get 132 over 6. We'll multiply 9 thirds by 2 over 2 to get 18 over 6. And we'll multiply 1 half by 3 over 3 to get 3 sixths. So now that everything is over 6, We combine them. We get 117 divided by 6, which if we divide both numerator and denominator by 3, we end up with 39 halves. So that's our final answer. 39 halves is the area between the graph of 9 minus x squared, which is that big arcing parabola, and the line x plus 1, which was straight. The area between those two curves, between the lines x equals negative 1 and x equals 2. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!